Hello and welcome to a brand new computer vision tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to do face anonymization. Face anonymization is a process whereby you detect a face and you decide to blur this face or hide this face for security reasons. And that's what we are just going to do in this tutorial. In my previous tutorial, we learned how to do face detection using YOLOv8. So we are just going to build on top of that particular tutorial by just selecting the face and blurring it. If you like computer vision tutorials, you like AI tutorials, and also love Python tutorials, subscribe to this channel and also put on the notification bell icon on so that you don't miss any of my future videos. Alright guys, so what we are going to do is to go to my GitHub repository and leverage the face detection code, so that we don't write the same code from scratch. So the link will be in my description, so I'll just go there, and when you come there, this is my GitHub repository, face detection, and then we just have to copy this code and paste it in our new PyCharm. So I'll open PyCharm and just paste this code quickly. So this code is for face detection, and now I have to place my video path here, the particular video I'll be using for this particular tutorial. So I have some list of videos here. I'll just copy this particular path and change the video name. So I'll place it here, and then the video I'm going to use is 10.mp4. So you guys should go ahead and change this to your video path. If you don't want to use your video and you want to use your camera too, you just have to replace this video variable here with 0. If you have many cameras, you can choose 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, depending on the number of cameras you are using. But we are using our video, so we just have to place the video here. So also, what I will have you to do is to download the face detection model. So I would love you to watch the previous tutorial whereby we downloaded the model, and also I'll show you the GitHub repository where you can download this model. So it's right here, and I'll make sure I put the link in the description. So we have so many models here which you can use. Where is it? Okay, so the particular model we are using today is still the face detection model, which is, so we have three varieties here you can choose from. Each of them, I've explained this in the previous tutorial, so I think if you are confused, you can watch that tutorial and be on the same page. So let's go back to our PyCharm, and what we'll do now is to run our video feed to see whether our face detection will get implemented. Boom, and here we go. So you can see right from the back, the code is working, no errors, we are detecting face. So the next step we have to do is to extract the coordinates, so the particular pixels where the face is being detected, we extract that particular pixels around the face, and then we blur that face. Then after that, we put that face back on the original face, then we are done. So that's all we have to do, and that's all we are going to do. So let's get it done. So I'll come to the down here, and then right after here, all I have to do is to extract the face. So for that, I'll call that one face, and this face is equal to, we have to extract the coordinates. So from the top side to the downside, that's exactly where the face is being detected. So let's extract that. So we take our video, and in this our video, we are just going to do some cropping. So we are going to crop that exact place. So we'll crop from Y1 and from Y1 to Y1, and then we add the height to it. This is all we have to do. Then for the X aspect, we do the same thing. We crop from X1 and then we add the width to it. So we've already extracted the width and the height here. We have done that calculation beforehand. So just type that one real quick. Okay, so this is all we need to do to get our face extracted, and we can show this. So I can go ahead and also show this. So what I'll do is we can copy this right here, and let's see if we can show. So we can call this one here face, and then here we'll call it our face, and that's all we need to do. So let's run this up. and here we go. So you can see this small window here shows our face. So these are the particular faces detected. So we have a list of faces. We can iterate through them and show each individual face, but I think all we want to know is that we are extracting the face coordinates accurately. So that's all we are concerned about. So now we'll go ahead and blur this face, and then after that we'll cast it back onto where we've extracted it. So let's now go ahead and blur this face. So we still see our face is equal to ucv2.blur, and in here what are we going to blur? We are going to blur our face, then we specify the kernel size. So we'll call it, we'll do it 30 by 30, and that's it. So this is how much of the blur we want to apply to this particular face. You can change this value per the results you want. You can change it, you can make it higher, lower, depends on how you want the blurring intensity to be. For me, I think 30 by 30 works, and it works great. We can also run it to see whether the face is being blurred. So you can see it's very small, but you can see there is some blurring happening there. So what you will do now is to go ahead and cast this back onto the original faces so that we can visualize it correctly. So we can say our video in the key of whatever we've extracted. So whatever we have extracted here, we want to bring it back. So we paste it here, and this is equal to our face. Okay, we have two distances. By doing this, we are putting the face bezels back to where we've extracted it. So we have the blur bezel actually there. So let's try this out and see. And here we go, guys. So you can see now we are detecting the faces, we are blurring the actual aspect. So this is how simple it is. You just extract that particular part of it and blur it. So this is how simple it is. I think this, guys, this is cheap, this is simple, everyone can do this. This is how simple it is. So in case you think is the particular box is not big, it's not covering the face enough, you can just add small pixels up. You can add some, let's say for instance, you can add like 10 to the height. So you can add like plus 10 to the height and plus 10 to the width to widen the particular face coverage. But we are not going to do that there. So in case you want to do that, you can just try that out. So now what we want to do is to combine both field where we have the input and the output. So we use CV zone for that. For that, I think we have to copy the main input video, which is right here. So we can call it main vid, or main video is equal to our video.copy. You can use copy on it, and that's all. So for the final step, we can use CV zone to stack everything up and show one frame containing both the detected face and the anonymized face. So you can call it all feeds. So CV zone dot stack images takes list of some images and stack them together. So in this case, we are giving it a video feed, so we can give it a list of video feed. We can give it our main video feed, and then also give it our video, and then this will go ahead and stack all together. What you have to specify is the number of columns you want. So in this case, you want it 2, and then how big should it be, which is the scale. So we'll give it 0 points. I think in my case 80 works pretty well. You can change it as per the size you want. And instead of showing the individual feeds here, we can just show all feeds, and that's it. We don't need to show this one again. So let me run this. Boom, and here we go, guys. So you can see here we have our main input video and the output video with the faces detected and anonymized. So everything works, guys. I think this is working great. It won't be bad if we can show the face detections on this particular input field, then this one will be the anonymized field. So let's do that. So I think what we should be doing is to draw the rectangles on it. We are feeding it, but we are not drawing anything on it. So we can copy this here, paste it here, and just change here to be our main video, and that's it. So let's run it for the last time and let's see our results. Okay, here we go. So this works now, guys. We are detecting the faces, and over here we are anonymizing the faces. So guys, this has enormous application in the computer vision industry, because in these days privacy is very key. So you need to hide people's face, because you are not going to, let's say, obtain permission from them. You are using online videos where you don't know the people. I think this is very useful if you can hide their face in any application whereby you are using people's video without them knowing. So this works great. I'll try this on another video. Let me check. I think we can try this on 6. So we can change 10 here to 6.mp4. Weird video names, I know, but it still works. Let's see how it will perform here. And great, it's performing great. So guys, I think this is nice. We are doing the job. And shout out to Autralities for this great model. I think it's working, it's very accurate. It's detecting faces with a very high accuracy. We are using the smaller version. We have the medium and also the large model there. You can choose anyone you want, but just make sure you have the computational power to run each of the models. So guys, we'll wrap up here. As usual, this code and everything will be on my GitHub repository. Everything we've used here will be on my GitHub repository. The link will be in the video description as usual. But make sure you subscribe, you give me thumbs up, and also you share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching, and as usual, I'll see you in the next tutorial.